Last week, I saw a brilliant tutorial by the fantastic Kevin Powell where he showed us how to create overlapping sections on websites.
Hello, my friend and friends. I recently had someone ask me how I could create a layout like this one here. This overlapping area was the main question that came up for them. And I thought it'd be a good video because I came up with two different solutions, or actually, I guess, three different solutions on how we could accomplish something like this. And yeah, we're going to dive into what they are.
So I thought it'd be really useful for you if I showed you how to create this using no code, no CSS, just WordPress blocks. Let's dive in. Start by typing /columns to add the columns block. I'm going to select 50-50 proportions. In the left-hand column, I'm going to copy and paste my text. In the right-hand column, I'm going to add the buttons block. And I'm going to type my button text. Then I'm going to select the columns block itself using the little breadcrumbs down below and vertically align all the content within the entire columns block by selecting align middle. Next up, I'm going to select the width icon in the toolbar, and I'm going to select wide width to give it a bit more breathing space. Then I'm going to select the buttons block, and I'm going to align that centrally within the right-hand column. Now I'm going to skip across to the right and select styles. Make sure I select the columns block itself using the breadcrumbs, and I'm going to give the whole columns block itself a background color. And then finally, for the columns block, I'm going to add some padding to the top and the bottom and the left and the right. And I'm also going to give it some radius as well to each of those little corners. So that's my inner container completed. Next up, I'm going to select the list view and I'm going to group the entire columns block. This is going to let me add a background to it. So next up, I'm going to make it full width by clicking on the align icon and selecting full width. And this is where the magic comes in. I'm going to select the stars icon over on the right. Now remember, I have the group block selected and I'm going to click on gradient in the color picker. And you see I've got two control points here. In the left one, I'm going to make that black. And in the right one, I just click on that and I'm going to make that fully transparent, so white essentially. And then I'm going to select the angle to 180 degrees. That means the darker colors at the top. And here's the magic. I select those control points and pull them together. So essentially they completely overlap to get a really sharp line behind my inner container. Next up, to finish off, I'm just going to add some padding to the top and the bottom. And there we go. You can now see my inner container is overlapping that effect. And because we've used core WordPress blocks, it works beautifully on mobile because we're just using the group block and the columns block. And the columns block in WordPress uses Flexbox, so it works beautifully intrinsically on mobile. Here's a bonus tip for you. If you want to get complete control where that gradient line intersects with your inner container, you can switch to the code view like I'm doing on screen. Then simply search for percent. And you can see the actual percent where your gradient is intersecting that line at the moment. For my side, it's 43%. So if I wanted it exactly in the middle of my inner container, I would just go in code view and select these all as 50%. There's only four of them. It doesn't take very long. Once you've done that, you can exit the code view editor by clicking on the little link up in the top right. And now you should have a completely bisected inner container with my gradient overlap. If you want to be even more snazzy, you can take things to the next level by adding additional control points into your gradient picker. You can see here I'm adding two more control points, choosing the same color for each one, that green color, the same color as my inner container. Then I drag those two control points so they're very, very close to each other. Then I drag my gradient pickers overlapping those, and you can see I get this extra nice little green line that again is intersecting with my inner container. It's a really nice, really easy effect to achieve. I hope you found that tip really useful and you can use it in lots of really creative ways to make your websites better. If you did find it useful, if you could hit the like button down below now, it'd be fantastic because it does make a huge difference in terms of how many people get to see this video. It really, really does. So thank you if you can hit the like button. And if you want to see more tips like this, hit that subscribe button because we've got a ton more coming your way soon. Thanks again for watching. Keep well and I'll see you soon. Bye for now.